Hi, welcome to iPersonally. Today we have most wanted, the most power-packed cameraman of India, Mr. K.K. Sindhil Kumar. Hi sir,
Swami Sharma.
Swami Sharma.
Welcome
Sharma.
To iPersonally. So,
thank you.
I'm going to ask something personally.
Yes.
Sir, starting from Atle with Chandrasekhar sir, your first movie, it was an action thriller.
It was not an action thriller, it was sort of, I can put it as...
it's a special genre of...
Yeah, it was a story about four friends who go through a very melodramatic lifestyle and other things. So it was, you can't call it as an action thriller, it's more of a suspense kind of a thing actually. Yeah.
It was a special genre where a cinematographer has to play a key role.
Actually what happened was like Telugu cinema till then had lots of glamour photography involved in all the films. So Aithe was one film where it had realistic approach in cinematography, because I was very fresh from Film Institute. So after I came from Film Institute, so I wanted to do something different. So I got a good script, good director, good producer, so I could try and do some realistic work in that. So, and I'm very happy with that it gave me good name after that film. So even in spite of it being a small film, because it was realistic, it stood out from the whole other films which were high budget, glamour. Suddenly a small realistic film stood out in a big way.
Sir, starting from your first movie, there was a metamorphosis. From the first movie to Bahubali. Yeah. So, can you explain that metamorphosis?
It has been, I have had a very blessed journey till now, like starting from Aithe, where I was a new cameraman, to after Bahubali, doing one of the biggest Indian motion picture. So, it has been a great journey. And every film I did helped me grow some bit or the other in some way. Every film I learned something new, so that I applied to my next film. And in that process, the way my work grew and I got good, better films than what I did earlier. So it has been a great journey. So I always feel I am very blessed to have such a long career.
Sir, in between these movies, you have done Makhi, Icha, and in Malayalam. It was a bilingual movie.
It was shot in Tamil and Telugu.
It was a challenging, I think the most challenging one of the movie in your career.
Because
it has a key role in the cinematography. So how challenging it was for you?
Before Iga, I did films which had lots of visual effects like Magadira and other things. But in that, the thing was, the visual effects was in the background. So here in Iga or Icha, like the central character, the hero of the film was a CG generated character. So it was a completely different challenge. Like when I was shooting other films where the CG was background, the way you shoot and the way you do things are different. And when your main character is not there on the set, then how you do it is quite a challenging. So in that way, like our director Rajmouli had a very clear vision of what he wanted to do. So we did lots of pre-production and other things, and we had to use lots of special equipments to can that. And till date, even after Bahubali, I think the most challenging film I shot was Iga, because you have to get the point of view of Iga, like how it sees the world, how a housefly sees the world and other things. So that was really a very challenging experience, and shooting every shot in Iga was quite a understanding of technology, understanding of techniques, and using it to give a correct output what the director wanted. So it was quite a laborious process.
There is a huge chemistry between you and Rajamouli. We can see in the screen.
Yeah.
So can you explain what sort of the chemistry you are keeping personally, even it's personally and professionally, with Mr.
See, like with Rajamouli, I started my my second film was called Sai. It was based on rugby. So that was the second first film with him. So that was released probably in 2004 or something like that. So since 2004, I have been working on so many films with him. So he is right from that time, he had a clear vision of what he wants. So he has lots of hunger for growth. He wants to do something better and better all the time. So which you can see from that time to this, like there has been a great growth in him. And being associated with him, so he is someone who is not easily what I can say pleased. If he wants something, he wants something, like how you want to do it. So it's always, so we I have to upgrade myself constantly to match to his standards. And thank God, like I have been like living up to his expectations. And there has been a great growth in him, and he pushes the whole team to grow with it. So he is someone, he is a great leader to follow, actually, like. So, and I am very proud about myself that I could live up to his expectations in each film. And now I am doing his next film called RRR. So which is again a very massive film in terms of content and in terms of budget and everything also.
So every filmmakers tell the content is the king, and the camera is the key role, the sword and the things which used to make the content.
No, so the cinema is a visual medium, like right from the time cinema grew, it is a visual medium. So visuals are very important aspect of filmmaking. So in between, like, okay, like some things come up, go, but at the end of the day, it is like people come to theater to watch the visuals. So it is a very important aspect. It's the basics of cinema, actually. Like if there is no visuals, it becomes a radio program. So people don't come to theater to watch, to listen. So they come both. It's an audio visual experience. And since cinema is a visual medium, so it is cinematography becomes a very integral part of it.
So you have a lot of risky shots in between Bahubali first and two, and can you remember some snaps of that things which happened that which is unforgettable for you while shooting Bahubali 2?
Bahubali right from the beginning till the end is been a memorable experience, right from the day we started to like the first schedule we shot in a place called Karnool. So we could not shoot there because like people came to know that okay, we are shooting there, Prabhas being such a big star and Rajamouli being there, so he had a huge following. So when we were shooting there, suddenly the whole, we were supposed to shoot at a very empty place. So we found a very remote location. Then when we started shooting, by the time it was 10 o'clock in the morning to 11 o'clock, we had some 30,000-40,000 people like gathering around. So one place we tried to clear, and another 1 hour the place is filled. So it was impossible to shoot. So then we decided, okay, we can't shoot Bahubali outside anywhere in AP. So we had to choose a studio location. So we shifted all the things to Ramoji. So we couldn't can. So from that time till the way Bahubali released in part two, the whole thing is a memorable journey. And if I tell, okay, one incident was better than the other incident, then it will be injustice. So every day it has been a great experience, and it is an experience to cherish for life. Because like the whole team, see, like in today's world of cinema, I don't think anyone works on a project for 5 years. So our team worked for 5 years together. So we gained each other's respect, each other's what I can say cooperation in pulling off such a massive thing. So every time I think of Bahubali, my heart really quenches, and like I am very proud of that, being associated with that film.
A few scenes of Bahubali has taken, Bahubali 2, the conclusion has been taken in Kerala, Kannur.
Yeah.
Especially the Chirakkal Kalidasan, that elephant has been shot in Kerala. Can you go through a small memory while shooting Chirakkal Kalidasan and the Kannur sequences?
See, like in Kannur we shot some portion of Devasena's introduction sequence, and The elephant actually, like, it was majorly CG generated elephant, and but the references we had taken from Chirakal, that places. So it was majorly shooting references there, but the actual elephant was majorly CG generated, like VFX generated, because animals, we can't tame them, like, and we wanted a certain elephant which was certain size, certain weight, walks and other things. So we but we need some references, okay, like, so I think the best thing we found was in Kerala is famous for elephants. Nowhere in India you find the kind of elephants you have in Kerala, so that was the best place. So we came there to shoot references and other things. And even in first part we shot in Mahogany Forest, the sequences where, like, Prabhas is found, and we shot in Chalakudi, the waterfall sequences. So the majority of Bahubali happened in either in Ramoji Film City or in Kerala. So in that way, like, Kerala is a major part, Kerala played a major part in Bahubali, actually.
Especially when you are treating with 4K content,
yeah.
Right now dual 4K content.
Yeah.
So how challenging it is while treating with 4K content?
See, when it comes to shooting, I don't think there is any difference when you are shooting like a 4K or a 2K or any or negative anything. It's a very creative process. Okay, like you have a scene. Director want to tell the scene in a certain way. So as a cinematographer, I use all my, like, lighting, lensing, camera movement and all those things, and to tell the story in the best possible way, helping my director what he wants. So content only comes when like in what format you want to release, like what is the preservation and all those kind of things comes. So then the obviously the better the resolution, the better the output. So in that way, like this RRR, we'll be shooting in true 4K of ARRI. ARRI has launched a new camera called ARRI LF. So I am shooting that, and I have seen a few results. I am like really like, okay, like 4K is really good in terms of resolution and other things, and people will definitely have a great experience watching, because see, now even the what I can say, TVs, you get lots of 4K TVs. It is no more like what I can say, HD TVs or anything. Like, the resolution of TVs are increasing, screens are becoming better, and Netflix, they the minimum content they accept is 4K. So 4K is now becoming a norm. So either you shoot 4K or you are like below, the category is low. So 4K is definitely the in thing and the future. So if you want to really shoot content which will last for some time, then probably the 4K is the thing.
So coming to RRR, how challenging the subject is to you, and your last movies were magnum opus movies, mm-hmm. and this is also a magnum opus movie, but how challenging you are doing with two mega stars of the industry, and how to balance with them, and how challenging it is.
See, balancing it all, like, we have Rajamouli as our leader. So when you have Rajamouli, he balances it, everything. He knows what is right and other things. So we blindly have to follow him, okay, like, and do what best we can do to help him. Then both Charan and Tarak are brilliant actors, more than stars, they are like great actors, both of them, and it will definitely be obviously it will be very challenging, and it is just in the initial stages, so it is too early for me to comment anything on this. So we are planning for release in 2020, so it's a long way to go. So we are after Bahubali, this actually I think is next level of doing things for us.
Okay, sir. Coming to this new movie, the last movie was a historic and epic movie. There was a lot of research, artwork, all going on. And this movie, the terrain is reflected nearby. It's the recently, I think 10 years, 20 years backstory, you are trying to tell, according to the reference we got. What are the terrain differences for a cameraman? And
see, like
See, like Bahubali was a completely fictitious story, fictitious time period and things. This we have in this film, we have a certain time period which we are doing. So we have to be more careful doing this film in terms of, and even after Bahubali. So after Bahubali, the whole country's eyes are on us. So we have to be very careful in doing everything. So since this is a time specific time period based, so our research work is definitely much more than what it was for Bahubali. Bahubali was fictitious and we could create anything and everything. So this we have to cater to a certain time period. So, okay, like what are the things available, how the costumes were, what are the look and feel of it. So we have almost spent an almost 6 months on 6 months or more than that on the pre-production, on 6 months to an year on pre-production of it, in terms of collecting all the references, research, and what are the things we want, how it should look and other things, and how we should sound, everything. So we definitely have more responsibility now after Bahubali than before. Yeah, and for pre-production we have definitely putting in more effort than what we have put in earlier.
Sir, when did you started to dream to become a cinematographer?
Actually, my case is a very special case. I never dreamt of coming into cinema at all. I actually wanted to get into my family background is my father is from the army, my cousins are in the air force and navy, and also it's a defense background. So no way art comes into my family. So I wanted to get into civils or like join the defense forces. So in the process I was preparing myself for the exam. So I was writing all the exams. So in the process I wrote the Film Institute exam. So I got through, and so I wanted to see like, okay, like what it feels. But the moment I entered Film Institute, it was like a magic open to me, like it was a Pandora's box open to me. And I was like really thrilled with the whole process of making films, because to me everything was new and it really fascinated me. So the moment my first day I entered Film Institute, I thought like, okay, like we had some orientation course. It was like interview. I had to attend an interview, and after the interview only our selection was happened. So when I entered the interview, I thought like, okay, like if I don't get in this year, I'll try next year and come into it, because that for that world of filmmaking is very, very fascinating. But God's grace, I got through in the first attempt. So here I am, you are interviewing me.
Yes, sir.
You said about the first day. Can you remember something about your first day as a student in Pune Film Institute?
Yeah, like I remember the first day we had, obviously like I went from Hyderabad to Pune in train, and early morning, and it's winter, around December or something like that, we had to, it was there. So it was really magical, like we have a straight road in the Film Institute, if you have been there, there's a main FTI entrance and a straight road. And early morning sunlight really is completely opposite. It is very photogenic actually, like. So, and it was all misty and all, it was really, I am telling you, it was magical, like
goosebumps
to me. Yeah, it was magical. So the first movie which I saw there was, it's called Red Beard by Akira Kurosawa. So somehow after seeing that movie, I was like, I was a big commercial fan guy, like to me, like great directors at that time were like Subhash Ghai or like Mani Ratnam, or like they are great directors, no offenses, but then like Raghavendra Rao sir and all those things. I never knew anything about parallel cinema or world cinema. The moment I saw Kurosawa's Red Beard, I was like blown out, like how can you make something like this? Then like that my interest really, and suddenly I was open to a new world of cinema. And I learned there that you can make films on literally anything and everything. So it was a completely eye opener for me, like, oh. And really, like that whatever I am today is thanks to the Film Institute. I have learned everything, my starting I have learned everything, because I don't have any background in filmmaking or anything like that. Like, I know where my father or like my brother or my cousin, anyone is connected to film industry. So whatever initially I have learned is from the Film Institute.
Sir, what makes you as a cinematographer happy personally?
Obviously, when you really do an interesting shot and you feel happy about it, okay, this is what I wanted to do and I got it, so really that makes me happy actually. Like, because it's like it's cinematographer job is not like okay, like one day or two days, it's a constant process, and every day, every shot you have to keep doing. So my thing is like I always try to give best in every shot I do. So what happens is when you keep trying doing things, so probably out of the 20 shots or whatever number of shots you do, maybe one shot will turn out magical. So for every shot you have to give your 100%. You shouldn't be thinking okay, like this is a simple shot, oh, leave it, for that interesting shot I'll do. So probably that simple shot might turn out to be really a great shot. So my thing is like I try to give 100% in it, and when I give 100% and I the results turn out to be dramatic, I really feel very happy about it.
How come all the frames are magical?
No, that's what I told. I try to give my 100%, whether people like it, don't like it, whatever. It's a simple close-up of a superstar or a simple close-up of some object. I try to give in my 100% and do justice to what it has to convey, whether my director wants it, why does he want this shot. So that every shot should convey something or other, what, and is it conveying the exact thing what my director wants. So I always try to put in my 100% into it.
Sir, personally and finally, I'm asking you one question. We are expecting you soon in Malayalam. So we are very soon, any projects coming in? We have heard a lot, like, you are coming to Malayalam, coming to
Yeah,
Malayalam.
Yeah, the thing is like I've got great offers from Malayalam, but somehow things are not materializing to the way we want it, like either from the production side or from our side. So with God's grace, something will materialize, and I'm also looking forward to work in Malayalam, because like in India, when you talk about talent, like Malayalis are like everywhere, and like the kind of immense talent which Malayalam film industry has, right, from the actors to directors to technicians, the world knows. So if I am a part of that industry, I'll definitely feel very happy and proud about myself.